Playing Tracy in this production at Westfield is just like really awesome.
The whole cast is pretty much just one really big family.
We're just amazing actors. Can't help it.
It feels amazing to hold such a large role in this show because I've always seen these productions and I've admired their professionalism. So to be able to see all the work that goes into this production really is so special.
I think that the difference between a Westfield Main Stage and a Westfield Summer Stage is during a Westfield Main Stage, there are kids only from Westfield, but during the Summer Stage, you get to pull kids from all over Virginia and you get to meet new people, you can have new opportunities, make new friendships, and for me, during the main stages, I was a runner for two of the shows. And now, for Westfield Summer Stage, I am part of the sound crew. So there are definitely new opportunities with each one. In the end, it's a lot of fun, and you get to see your hard work pay off.
What inspired me to do Summer Stage is I really love the musical Hairspray to put a shine a light on what's going on. I wanted to be a part of something that could changed the world basically, and I never really did done Summer Stage before, so I was just like, I really like this. Like,
the cool thing about Summer Stage is that it's treated like a main stage. Majority of the production is run by the students, such as props, makeup, publicity, costumes. A lot of the times the actors are found in like leadership positions or just, you know, craftsmen. On stage, next thing you know, you're like brushing a wig or making a poster or sewing your costume, and it's very involved, but I think it's worth it in the end, and it like teaches like a valuable lesson about, you know, being a well-rounded artist, and I think that's fantastic.
I've had to balance between doing sound, but I also auditioned for the show, so I am the prison matron, and doing that has been a struggle because I've been focusing on sound stuff, and then I was like, oh wait, I have lines. That's weird. I should start learning those. That would be a good plan. But now since we're running the show, what I have to do is I do the whole first act. So I have an assistant, she runs cues, right? So I run the mics for the first act, and then I leave during intermission and get dressed, and I do my whole prison matron thing. And then I get out of all my costumes, and I put everything away, and I gave her from Big Dollhouse to Timeless Reprise, so that I would have plenty of time, and that she would get practice on the board, so it's like a it's a give and take situation, which is good. I like it. I think it's worked out.
I feel that the hardest transitions for runners are Welcome to the 60s because people are helping with quick changes and there's like a lot going on. And Big Blonde and Beautiful because midway through the song we have to push stuff forward, like, and it's hard.
Pretty much without tech, it would kind of just be actors acting, which is it's great, but you wouldn't have the kind of what makes it itself a show. You wouldn't have the like location, and it would be dark and no one would really be heard. So that's definitely why tech is really important.
I call myself a tactor. I take both theater and tech. It is so important to me that I have multiple skills. I could go and be a tech on Broadway or be a runner, or it just opens a lot more doors to me, and it's honestly like a craft I like want to master because I write plays, I direct stuff, I write music. It's just part of like being a master of all cards, I guess. So right now I'm a tactor. Hopefully I'll be able to add more weird acronyms to it by the end.
I love dancing. It's something that brings out like a different, I feel like I'm in a different world when I'm dancing. I feel like when I dance, I just block everything else out and just do what I can do.
I think I identify with a lot of characteristics of Seaweed. He's very charismatic, you know, he talks a lot, and just really smooth with everything he does, which that's what I try to do all the time. Just be cool, calm, collected. He's definitely a family man. You can see that he cares about his sister, his mom, and all the people around him that he just considers his family.
The characteristics of Penny that I relate to are I'm like super duper awkward all the time. I don't know what I'm doing. Yeah, I'm just really awkward.
I probably relate to Penny the most. Penny's like a little ditzy and she's a little like, she's always just so, like, she's so supportive of Tracy and she's really open to any idea that anyone's throwing at her.
I think that, like, in every evil character, there's a lot of positives. So in the Von Tessels, like, mm-hmm. Amber and Velma, they're go-getters, they're determined. Like, once they put their eye on something, like, they're gonna get it. And I think that is something that people can look up to, like, having mm-hmm. such good determination.
Yeah, and also it's the fact that the characters, you know, we've had to search for within the characters themselves is finding something they do like in order to kind of root for them and really get in character and respect who they are as individuals. Because, I mean, at the end of the day, the only quality I like of Velma is the fact that she's confident and she's willing to go out and get what she wants, like Susanna said. Because, I mean, if they change their morals and they use those same qualities, then they're good people.
I think my character evokes change throughout the production by taking strong positions whenever he's faced with this difficult situation. I played Courtney Collins in middle school, and it's a little different this time because here there's a couple of scenes where I can really state my opinion and like really show where my character stands on the issues, and I think that's pretty good.
Not only are the Dynamites amazing performers, they are amazing activists for what they believe in.
I love Motormouth because I get to show a pride for my race and a confidence that I feel like black women and black girls have had like taken away from them, or people have tried to like downplay them, and to be playing someone who's so big and vibrant and just proud, I'm very like excited for the role, and I'm fully immersed in it.
Edna, for one, is like very, she's not strict, but she cares, and she doesn't want Tracy to end up getting hurt. So a lot of the time she thinks that by telling Tracy she can't go out and do these things, it's gonna help her. But then towards the end, I think she realizes that Tracy's just trying to become herself and she's trying to do what she wants to do. So then Edna supports that by, she ends up going on that march in Big Blonde and Beautiful, and she joins in the riots and the protests.
I think that from the start, Wilbur, on the other hand, is like the opposite of Edna in that way, that he's, from the start, he's the yes man, he's encouraging her, and he's telling her to follow her dreams, and that with him being an ambitious person as well, and just being a very laid-back individual, he wants to be that one who's encouraging, while Edna's the one who wants to keep her in check and keep her realistic.
Link's most important trait in the character as well as the story is his courage, as well as his caring. His courage to break the social norms of, you know, pretty boy. But it's very different to fall in love, especially in the time of the 60s, fall in love with someone who's not considered to be pretty by the social standards. So it took a lot of courage on Link's part to forget what is expected of him.
I mean, there's some struggle that comes with playing Tracy. I mean, she's a bigger person, and as someone who's struggled with their weight, it brings out a lot of insecurities about yourself. You have to get used to all the jokes you hear, like when all these jokes people are saying, which you know are lines, but you know you recognize them. You feel like they're real. But Tracy's been a dream role of mine since I was, like, when I first found out about her in middle school in 7th grade. And I've just been actively looking for her, and I just thought I auditioned, and when I got it, I was ecstatic, because this is this big person who isn't just a big person. She's a hero. She believes in so much more. Her label isn't just being that person. She cares so much about other people and she wants to change that.
But the reason I decided to audition this time instead of just doing tech was because Tracy's so iconic as being like the big girl in theater. Like she's like, you think about like who's like, everyone else is like skinny, like who's like large and in charge in more ways than one. And that's Tracy Turnbull. I was so scared that like some like skinny girl was gonna like go up on stage and sing Good Morning Baltimore with like pillows under her dress. And I was like, no, I'm gonna give these girls a run for their money, because you know, I could aesthetically play this role. Singing and dancing, the acting, okay. But like, I look the part, so it's whatever.
I think a big part of onstage chemistry is offstage chemistry of some sort.
Kind of getting the chemistry between our characters, Edna and Wilbur, it was kind of helped through like outside hangouts. He and I, as being comedic actors, we found it pretty easy to get along in that sense. And it being friends offstage, it makes it just a lot easier to let go of the awkwardness and just be a couple on stage.
And I think there's still some awkwardness, but that adds to like the actual characters, because they're older and they're not like young and hip and like just fell in love, because like we been in a relationship for probably 20 years now, and having that connection off stage, like we said, and it's very much us off stage still on stage, because we're just funny. We're really funny.
We created such a strong sisterhood with one another. Like, we can go to each other if we have a problem. Like, we work really well together. And that chemistry is just something that you really need, especially with the parts that we're playing. It's just, you need to have that chemistry. And I feel like we've gotten to that point, because it was kind of weird coming in, because it was like, oh, we don't really know each other. But then, like, as the week's gone by, we just got so close to one another.
During lunch, we all just kind of, like, get together and, like, we talk. And, like, we genuinely have a good time. Like, it's like one big family luncheon. And, like, not only that, but we all go through stuff during the day and, like, at home, and then we come here, and it's kind of just like you put all that stuff aside for a quick second, and you just, like, genuinely have a good bond with everyone. I genuinely enjoy coming to rehearsal just to see, like, my family, because, like, I'll have a rough day, and I'll, like, who knows what will happen, but I know that when I come to rehearsal, I'll be able to enjoy myself.
Whatever happens on the show days, I know that these two lovely ladies have worked their butt off to get to the point that we're at right now.
Stop it!
I like to try to get to know my Motormouth gang. Like, some of them are very quiet, or some of them don't know each other, and, you know, even if I'm just walking past them and they're, you know, quiet, maybe having a bad day, I just, you know, talk to them and stuff like that. And I bring them all for meetings to either tell them I'm proud of you or we need to work on this, you know what I mean? I'm the voice of reason and the voice of strength and getting them all together, and I just really like that the Motormouth gang has become an actual family of some sorts.
In the cast, I would say the Tracy to my Penny is probably Benji, just because I've known him for a pretty long time, like since elementary school, and we kind of like encourage each other to do stuff a lot. Like, we encourage each other to audition for this, and that has turned out to be a lot of fun. I think honestly theater has helped me like come out of my bubble.
The message of the show is very important because it tells the story of a time where not everyone was accepted for who they were, whether it was their size, race, ethnicity, or even, you know, just the way that they looked.
I have been through that. I have been judged because of my color and because of how, you know, I am.
It's hard being African American, but it's something that I'm proud to be, and I wouldn't want it to be anything else.
The Dynamites are supposed to be this figure of, especially in like the music business, like women of color weren't taken seriously. Any POC was not taken seriously. And they would create these wonderful shows, and they'd put on a show for these people, but they wouldn't be taken seriously because they didn't get the chance. And the Dynamites, they just enforce this kind of like, we are here, we are amazing, we should be validated. Women of color have been through so much. And, you know, having these characters be like these empowering females going on stage and just, you know, killing it. Oh, it's just, if it's done right, which is a lot of pressure on it, if it's done right, it just can add like just imagine a little girl in the audience, you know, not seeing that on stage, because of course they see like a bunch of other females on stage, but just having like a woman of color on stage and just tear it up. That'd be so amazing.
I think it's important that we do this show today because there are situations nowadays that we have to face.
This is a perfect time to speak out and not be silenced so quickly, because during the end of my number, Big Blonde and Beautiful, like, we're peacefully protesting and we're getting arrested. Like, that still happens, but we have a little bit more leverage. You know what I mean? It's sad that we still do tend to get shut down or tend to be overlooked or silenced.
There's a lot of fear behind playing such big and negative personalities because people don't want to be disliked, but that's like our entire job on stage is to be disliked, but the entire plot wouldn't go through if there wasn't a reason, if there wasn't an antagonist, because we're the ones showing the bad parts of life during that time.
Also, I think the issue is a lot of people don't understand, don't want to admit, especially when they see it on stage, that like this is a thing that, as much as I hate to say it or admit it, people like this still exist to this day, and you have to see them on stage, otherwise you're not portraying like what
the reality was.
The reality is and what it was, and like, you know, in all honesty, what it still is today. Because otherwise, I mean, what's the point of doing art if you're not gonna send a message to the audience and send a message to people. So I don't think there's a fear, because at the end of the day, you know, we're actors and we understand that we're characters, but we also understand the importance of being these characters.
If you just think about it as like you, it's not you as a person, it's your character, and you have to do justice to that character no matter who they are and like what their beliefs are.
That's where we start to make a change.
If you're not working together, then, you know, you have nothing there.
If I had to pick a musically climactic part of the production, my first instinct would be to say, I know where I've been, just because at that point, we've been through a journey, and it's about to come to like this whole fruition, and it really sets the message of, this is part of something greater. This is more than just a TV show. It's more than just, I want us to dance together on TV. It's serious. So we see that perspective right before the big finale, and everything kind of just ties itself together.
I think the most challenging group number is You Can't Stop the Beat, because there's just so many people. My favorite part about that dance is probably when you see like the tone like shift.
You know, I think it just gives us an opportunity to just let our freak flag fly and just accept ourselves for who we are.
Yeah, dance it off.
It makes me so happy. I hope that when we go on that stage that we're sharing a message and that we move people. What I want to take away from this show is that how to like work with different types of people, especially like people from other schools that, you know, are used to like a different way of like doing things and getting along with those kinds of people, and also like taking on really challenging like characters. This show's a great time. It's a great time. It's funny. It's lighthearted, but there's also an important message. And we work really hard. We worked really hard in these couple weeks, and it's gonna be a good time. So you better come in and see it.
Come see Hairspray!
That's good.